Hi, I'm Rhonda Wepler. I'm an artist in residence at the Museum of Arts and Design here in New York City, and I'm on another week of making some art projects on my dining table.
I often make artworks from materials found in my kitchen, like this community collaborative digital photo mural that was initially made with a lot of sprinkles. This series of tutorials will show you how to use materials from your kitchen and home to make gifts that fit in a standard size envelope to mail to friends and family. This project was inspired by this linoleum print by artist Wayne Thibault. Look, it's my Matchbox bubblegum machine sprinkle dispenser. This little artwork can be a helpful gadget around the kitchen. Here are the materials you'll need for this project. Please pause the video here to get a closer look. To fit into a standard size envelope, you will need to cut a matchbox down to less than a quarter inch thickness. Measure and mark the top of the box first. Remove the matches and open up the box first using your fingers to pry open, then scissors to separate. Flatten and cut a little above the quarter inch mark to make sure the box is thin enough. Trim the bottom half of the box to leave small tabs so that you can later glue the top to them. Place the two halves together and remeasure to make sure it is thin enough. Now you will have to make the tray fit your smaller box. Mark the tray so that it will fit in the narrowed cover. Trim down the tray, it will be very thin. Test that the tray still fits. The ends of the tray may need to be glued again. Throughout making this project, make sure to wipe off excess glue so you don't mistakenly glue the box shut. You can use paper clips to help clamp things down while glue dries. Find a lid that is no larger than 1 inch in diameter. This will be the stencil for the window. You will need two strips of cardboard, box type cardboard, for the inside mechanism of the box, one to go above the window and one to go below. Measure and cut the height of each. These strips will have to be no higher than the inside tray once folded. Cut and fold to fit. Make sure the lid you will be using still fits. And do not glue the cardboard pieces in yet. With a permanent marker, trace a lid on the top of the box so it will clear the two pieces of cardboard once assembled. Cut out the window. Trace the top on a piece of white cardstock and cut it out. Trace the card to make a back cover. Trace a third piece, the same size, that will eventually be your sides. Cut the window out of the cardstock for the front. Mark where the opening will be for the gumballs. It will need to be close enough to the bottom of the box so that another hole the same size can fit on top of it under the window. Use a hole punch to punch it out. Use this as a stencil to punch the top of the box to match. Put the top of the box on the tray. Slide the top up a quarter inch and mark the hole. Punch the hole out. Now you can glue the cardboard pieces into the tray. Be sure to use non-toxic white glue. To cover the cardboard pieces, cut pieces of white cardstock to fit as shown. Spread with a thin layer of white glue and place something on it so it will stick. To make a window for the bubblegum machine, you will need a piece of clear plastic. You can cut this from a plastic juice bottle using a box cutter knife. or use a clamshell box and scissors. Cut the corners off so that there's more contact area for the glue around the plastic. Spread white glue thinly but evenly around the whole top of the box. You want to make sure it does not ooze too much. Place the plastic. Sandwich the cardstock on top. You can clamp with paper clips. Glue the cardstock to the back. Once dried, you can rub out any dents left by the paper clips. The top half of the box will glue over top the bottom half of the box as shown. Spread a very thin layer of white glue evenly over both tabs. Make sure the glue does not ooze out and thus jam the tray. With the tray in the bottom half, adhere the top. While the glue is still wet, make sure the tray can still move easily. To make the sides, trace the sides on white cardstock to fit. Cut and glue the sides on. I couldn't figure out a way to clamp the box without denting the card, so I just held it for about 5 minutes. You can use markers like this version, pencil crayons, collage, or any other medium you'd like to use. However, the next steps will show you how to paint it using acrylic paints. First, draw your design in with a pencil. I am using very cheap acrylic paint and layering it up. First, I paint the whole thing in a red. Also paint the card strips in the tray. The paint dries quickly, so you can layer it up easily. I'm painting it all over again to make it a good solid red. Now I'm dipping my brush in a little bit of blue and mixing it to make the red dark. My shadow on the right side of the machine is dark, so I just paint that part with a dark red. I make a pink and put that on the left side of the machine. Between colors, I wipe my brush. I brush another clean layer of red between the dark red and the bright red. I clean my brush and make an aqua color by putting white with blue and a little bit of green. I paint the bottoms of the tray. Now I'm painting the whole background of the machine in layers of this aqua color. I start to add more blue and more green as I go to make it a more mottled color. I'm planning to put a note on the back, so I'm going to leave a white patch in the back. You can see I'm adding more blue and green here to make the bottom of the box a bit more dark to give it some depth. To make the handle and coin receptacle, I used aluminum foil and black paper or white colored in with a black marker. Stack the paper and foil and punch. Stacking keeps the edge sharp on the foil. I draw a small line across the foil part with a permanent marker to suggest a handle. Now, glue both the circles onto the box using a little bit of white glue as shown. You can glue a piece of white card in the back. This will provide a nice bright background for the bubblegum balls. Packing tape seals a card to make it water resistant. First, cut pieces to fit the inside painted areas. Fold over to the back. For the opening, make sure to cut a little square out of the tape. Stick it down and trim the edge before folding it to the back. Also cover the back and front of the matchbox. Start with the front and fold to one side, trimming first to fit. Notice the little note I glued onto the back before I put the tape on. Punch the hole for the opening. Now place the tape on the back. Trim and fold over one edge. Remember to burnish the window a bit if any bubbles got trapped. Slide the tray in. pour the sprinkles in. It's ready for action. If your box ended up too thick to fit in a standard envelope, you can always send the sprinkles in a baggie, take the tray out, and take the top and flatten a bit so the recipient can assemble them all together themselves. This little machine is going to my friends Jackie and Marty on Bowen Island in British Columbia.
Well, thanks for watching. Next time we'll be making fly mobiles. Stay safe out there.